after we have worked hard all week and get to come and worship together. We're excited about this morning. It is Youth Sunday, and we're going to celebrate our graduates. So we are excited that the youth are bold enough to come forward and to seek to lead worship, because it's one thing to sit there and to participate in worship, and it's another thing to try to figure out how it works up here. So we are so thankful for them, and we are praying blessings over them as they seek to guide us. And I'm going to turn it over.
Hello. Today the announcements are going to be on the screens or in your bulletin. And is there any announcements you'd like to share?
In the bulletin it mentions there's a sign-up sheet for Vacation Bible School. If we failed to get that up on the bulletin board, so it will get up this week. Please keep praying for Bible School. And we've got a lot of places that that we have means for help for that week. So please pray about it and sign up.
Anybody?
Good morning. Thank you for allowing the youth to serve you this morning. Before I do the invocation, I just need to tell you we are experiencing some small technical difficulties, so just bear with us this morning, okay? Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your blessing and fellowship, Lord, that we can come to your house and we can worship, and we can worship you freely, Lord. I ask your blessing upon this service and your blessing upon these young people who seek to serve you. Lord, your gift of these youth to our church has truly been a blessing for so many of us, and I thank you for the people that you have allowed to pour into their lives. So, Lord, we ask your presence here, and we invite the Holy Spirit to just enter this room. We, in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. please stand and turn here in the Faith Museum to 2164 Sanctuary?
Also ask a special blessing to be placed upon them as they go forth to serve you. Lord, we thank you for this church that has helped to nurse and care for them. And we pray that they would continue to serve you and to find a place to pray and to serve and to worship. Lord, we thank you for this time of celebration. We ask for your comfort to be upon their families as they are about to experience change. And we ask for your guidance to be upon each person. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
If our children will come forward.
I have a question for y'all today. Have y'all ever sinned? Yes? Why'd you hesitate? I was about to say, if you haven't sinned before, then I don't need to be up here. You're fine. Alright, so when I was about your age, I used to sin too. Well, all of us sin. We all sin. But specifically, when we were eating dinner, my mom would say, alright, Isaac, after dinner you can have one cookie. And so I take one cookie, put it in one pocket, take another cookie, put it in the other pocket, and then take one and eat it in front of her. And when she wasn't looking, I'd go around the corner and eat the other two. She didn't know about that one. Alright, but in the passage that Brayden's going to be speaking about today, it says that even though we have sinned, even though we fall short of God's glory, even though we mess up, we're still saved through Him. Because Jesus came and lived a perfect life, never ate too many cookies, always obeyed His parents, never committed one single sin, He was able to come and take our place on that cross. Amen. We didn't deserve it. We don't deserve it. We still don't deserve it. But because of His love and grace and mercy, we're able to be able to see Him again someday in heaven. Alright, so can we pray? God, thank you. Thank you for these kids. Thank you for this church. Thank you for being holy and mighty. Thank you for sending your Son from the absolute highest of highs in heaven to come down to be just a normal person, but to save us all so that we can be with you again someday. Lord, we love you and we praise you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Gracious God, use these offerings and all that we have for the building up of your work in this church and the world for your glory. Amen.
So kind to me. All the old. being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Will you please remain standing and join me in singing All My Hope, which will be seen on the boards.
Ah.
Y'all didn't know you had that kind of soul this morning, did you? It's good to try things and do something a little different. We are thankful for that. As we come together this morning, a couple of celebrations I want to make sure that I share with you. We know there were folks in and out of this church all through the past week, and we thank every single person that helped with the yard sale, those that we saw and those that we did not see, because we know that folks have been working for a long time on that. And we want to announce and celebrate with you all that the total right now is we raised $3,455.55. So we are very, very thankful and celebrate the blessings that God has given to us. And more importantly, we celebrate all the folks that got to come in and through the church and talk with us and walk with us. And we got to spend time with them yesterday. So we are thankful for that. Want to remind you as we sing about hope that our Hope Golf Tournament is coming up next Saturday. And if there are ways, if there are businesses that you think may sponsor a hole, we hope that you will contact Bruce or one of the other United Methodist men and let them try to work that out. If you play golf or have a group of folks that attempt to play golf, it's okay. We would love for you to do that. And if not, if you will show up and just help along the way and be in prayer for that event, we certainly appreciate it. And it is a new month. It is the new month of May. And so we come together this first Sunday of the month of May. We celebrate birthdays and anniversaries. Who?
Mark. Happy birthday.
He was trying to sit with his parents. All right, who has May birthdays? Please stand. Share with one another those joys and those concerns that you would lift up.
I just want to add to what you said about the yard sale. Thank you so much to all the people who baked things. I was overwhelmed with how much food.
Yeah, you had to get extra tables out for the bake sale part of things. And it was great. There's still a couple goodies left out there, so many wants to try them out. I'm sure we'll share, won't we? So a big thank you for all those that helped and cooked. Tina.
Prayer for my last chemo on Tuesday.
All right. We're going to pray for Tina's last chemo on Tuesday. Amen. Pat.
Today is a very special day for me. Brayden, I can't say enough about how proud I am of you. Have you followed God to sit there to do what you're doing? I'm so proud of you. And Raven, I can't be proud of you. For you, when you sing for God, that makes me so happy. I'm just so proud of both of you. And I know Ray's looking down very happy. And I want to thank you and Chris for being the parents they are, for bringing them up, knowing God, and leading them to Him. Thank you both for giving me such a wonderful friend.
Maybe those people in Hawaii.
Okay, let's remember those folks in Hawaii. You covered your mouth.
Sabra
Klein. I'm sorry.
She was my daughter's roommate at Hawassi.
Okay.
She lost her husband this week. Junior, late 20s.
Okay. All right, so we want to pray for Sabra Khan's family. She lost her husband this week. Fine. Let's cover them in prayer.
Friend of mine, Tommy Smith, from the trade center.
Okay.
Found a cyst in his brain. Do brain surgery. He's down below underneath the, what they call that, the cortex. Is that his home?
Tommy Smith. They found a cyst in his brain that he's going to have surgery.
Okay. And another friend of mine, Shane Smith, from work.
Shane Smith from work, his family, he passed away of cancer on Friday. Definitely cover them in our prayers. That camera right there is throwing me off. I'm not going to stand right in the news. So let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for this time to gather together to celebrate the wonderful events that you have allowed us to be a part of as this great church of hope, as we seek to be part of one another's lives as brothers and sisters, and as we seek to be part of the community. Heavenly Father, we ask your prayers and your guidance to be upon our nation and our country and those that are seeking to lead it. Gracious God, we ask for your prayers and guidance, our prayers and your guidance to be upon the United Methodist Church and those that are seeking to lead it and to make critical decisions around that. Heavenly Father, as we gather together this morning, we thank you for our graduates and that milestone in life. We also ask that you would provide comfort and grace and peace to those that are missing loved ones that have suffered loss recently, that are struggling with things that we do not understand, Lord, but you do. And you come alongside them, and you guide them, and you are with them. Let them know of your great presence this morning. Gracious God, as we continue to worship, I ask that you would pour out your Holy Spirit here upon this place, that you would cover each person, and that they would have your eyes and your hands and your feet, that we would see each other anew this day, and that we would once again decide to serve you. And that we would demonstrate by doing so our great faith in you as you call us to be people of faith and hope and love. And we pray together the prayer that your Son has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good thing, a little faith is all I have. For this opportunity to do this, and also like to thank you guys for believing in me and supporting me in this journey, and I speak on behalf of the other graduates, and thank you for everything. Now, let's get it. The reason I titled this sermon, Give Me Faith, is because Elevation Worship has a song called Give Me Faith, and it's got a line that says, when my flesh may fail, my God, you never will. So, when I look at verse 18, and we look at verse 18, Paul says, nothing good dwells in my flesh, and I desire what's right. But the evil I do not desire is what I keep doing. So then he keeps going with this and says, now if I do what I do not want to do, it is no longer I who do it, but it is sin living in me that does it. So if we know that we have sin, and we know it's wrong, like it says in Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. Then why do we keep sinning? It's not God's doing, but it's our own doing. So, like, when I feel I'm not a sensitive person, but I am today.
Bless him, Jesus.
So when I feel like alone in my sorrow and dead in my sin, and I feel like really lost with no hope, no place to begin, but I do. I praise God for Romans 5:8, which says, "But God demonstrates His own love for us in this, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." So I thank God for this amazing grace-giving verse. Say that my past does not define me because my future has been written for me. So, as a kid that wouldn't have had said hey unless I truly knew you, I have to give you a lot of credit. So to not say hey unless I truly knew you, to coming up here and doing this, I can go deeper another time if you'd really like me to. But if you want to talk about fully letting your future be written for you, look at me. It was like, if I could get a... If I get away from God, it was like a gut punch coming back. But now, I can just go, God, I'm broken inside.
Let God work through your brokenness.
So maybe I can work through that. I give you my life, it's yours, take it. I'm weak, but your spirit is strong in me. So when I fail, oh my God, you never will. So now, Romans 5:8 isn't saying you can just do whatever you want and hopefully the good will outweigh the bad things. No, it's much more than behavioral modification. It's about heart transformation. Heart transformation is much bigger than behavioral modification. When you truly let Jesus in your heart, you have heart transformation. It leads you to a lifestyle where you are called a son or daughter of God, and you are justified and called righteous. Because of Christ, in Christ alone, I am redeemed. And it becomes... where it's more than just reading through the Bible, it's the Bible reading through you. I was listening to a pastor one time by the name of Ed Newton. Shout out youth group. And he just ordered a pizza on Super Bowl Sunday, so they said it'd be like an hour and a half till they get delivered. So he said, okay, I can pick it up. How long? They said, 40 minutes. So, 20, 30 minutes later, he gets ready, gets his keys, his wallet, and he heads out the door. Guess who's standing there? The pizza guy. And so, we open, he says, dude, I think you've got the wrong house. He goes, I just deliver the pizzas. I don't make them. I'm in the wrong house. And so they do the normal exchange as you do with your pizza guy, you know, money. Is it cold outside and stuff? And so as the guy is walking away, Pastor Newton just randomly goes, hey, what do you think about Jesus? He doesn't ask for his name or anything. He's just like, hey, What do you know about Jesus? And the guy turns around and says, he says, I'll come to Jesus. I'll come to Jesus when I keep this drug habit. I have this job to feed my drug habit. Pastor Newton replies with, yo man, no, you've got that backwards. It's not you kicking your drug habit and coming to Jesus. It's you coming to Jesus and let Jesus kick in your drug habit. So this guy falls to his knees, comes to Christ. So when you let Christ in, great things will happen. Because my name is written in the Lamb's book. In Christ, He is my tabard. In Christ, I'm no longer a victim. In Christ, I fight from victory, not for victory. That's not done. And so, Romans chapter 6, verse 14 says, for sin will not rule over you, for you are not under law, but under grace. Yeah. You see, God could care less about behavioral modification. Because without heart transformation, you are nothing. Like Ezekiel 36:26 says, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will remove you. Oh God, remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. So like Ed says to the pizza guy, hey bro, you got it wrong. So are you the pizza guy? Will you say, forget my past, I'm going to let God write my future? That's rough. I believe that's all I got. So.
Amen.
A lot of grace and prayer and discernment to stand up here that we forget about sometimes when we see folks on TV and other places and they make it look easy. And so what a great opportunity and blessing that Brayden has provided for us to see. And we get to see children grow up, right? Our children, because we're called to be brothers and sisters in Christ and we're responsible for one another. So. As we come together this morning, we finish our time together. We know that Jesus was the best pizza delivery guy ever, right? He came, and when he sat around the table with the disciples, he offered what he could to them in hopes that their hearts would be open to him and continue to serve him, even though he knew that someone around that table would betray him and be lost. And so we gather together this morning as one of the gifts that God gives us in Holy Communion. And we gather around that table knowing that everyone is welcome at the table who seeks Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. It's not a United Methodist table. It's not my table. It's not your table. It's God's table. So we come for God's glory and God's grace that He provides here at this table. Let us pray. Gracious God, as we have heard the word proclaimed and read, as we have heard the word sung and said, as we have heard the word preached, and as we have hopefully been taught to this morning, Lord, we ask for your blessings and your guidance to be upon us. We ask for your Holy Spirit's outpouring to continue to be upon the young and the old, the new and those that are seasoned, Lord. As we all come to your table, those things are cast aside and we come as your children, as those seeking you with broken hearts, with hurt and pain. As we come this day, Lord, help us to receive your love and grace through your Son, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for us, for our sins, so that we would seek him and through him all things are possible. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, so that we can be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Make us one with you, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory. Heavenly Father, please bless these items, and please bless each person that comes to receive them. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Body of Christ broken for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. I said, Gabby, come forward to help you serve this morning. We will serve by intention, and we will just let you come as you feel led to come. Sometimes we make communion look like we'll serve the choir first and then we'll turn to the congregation. But sometimes we make communion look like it's all nice and neat. But folks at that table, there was noise and chaos and there were messes and things got spilled and everything isn't always nice and neat. But God calls us to come anyways. And so we will serve the choir first and then we will serve you all. If you have special dietary concerns, just give us a nod and we'll make sure to get the gluten-free items for you.
And cleanse every part of me. strong in me. My flesh may fail. My God can never win.
Gracious God, we thank you for this time to be at your holy table. We ask that each person that has come has been nourished with your great love and great hope. Gracious God, we receive that love and hope from your Son, Jesus Christ. May we continue to serve him all of our days. It's in Jesus Christ's name that we pray. Amen.
Can you please stand and sing Unstoppable God, we will see you on the stage.